What if I told you that I cut my working time in half without working harder? Just smarter. Look, the biggest mistake I see most people make when it comes to AI and saving time is that they think that AI will just do their job entirely. Like, for example, in my case, I edit a lot of videos, right? So what a lot of people think when I say that AI is saving me so much time these days is that I give AI a bunch of raw footage and then it will edit it, add B-roll, color grade it, add music, basically deliver a finished video. But that's obviously not how it works. Maybe in, I don't know, 5 to 10 years, but right now, what decides if AI works or not, if it will save you time or not, is you and your brain, your creativity. You still control AI, for now. So let me show you the different ways I use and leverage AI to save time. Okay, and the first thing I want to show you is that, well, you're probably already using so many AI tools without even knowing it. Everything has AI now, right? Adobe apps, your phone, smart speakers, cars, and also the video editing program I'm using all the time, DaVinci Resolve, introduces new AI features with every update. But here's the thing, not every new AI feature, not every update will help you. It's like going to a hardware store when you're doing some home improvement. Not every tool in the hardware store will help you paint the wall, for example. You know what I mean? Same thing with AI features. You have to find the ones that will help you. For example, a few AI features that I use all the time in DaVinci Resolve. First of all, Magic Mask. I use it when I want to put text behind something or someone. I use it to color grade, but you can also use it in combination with other features, like Relight, for example. So it's possible that Magic Mask on its own is not very useful and time-saving for you, but maybe in combination with something else, it is. Combining AI tools with other tools, that's the real power of AI. And also, you know, every company is adding a ton of AI features with every update, right? But that doesn't mean that every new AI feature will save you time. Again, DaVinci Resolve as an example. They added a bunch of new features with the Resolve 20 update, and a lot of them I find super interesting and useful, but I won't use them enough to significantly save me time. The only new one that I'm using a lot and that is saving me time, even though it's not perfect yet, is the new music editor, which allows you to seamlessly lengthen and shorten music tracks. So what I want to say is, don't just blindly buy something new just because it has AI. No, first check if the AI that it has, that it will help you, that it will do something for you. The key with all these built-in AI features is that you have to actively research and look for features that will help you. And trust me, you only need one or two to already save you hours every week. Okay, so that's for the built-in AI tools in editing programs and stuff like that. But then we also have the generative language model AI chatbots, like ChatGPT, for example. Now, I'm using mainly ChatGPT at the moment, but that doesn't mean that you have to use ChatGPT. Gemini, Claude, Perplexity, I mean, there's so many. Again, it's a matter of finding the one that fits your needs. But let me show you how I use it, how it saves me a lot of time. And first, there's how it helps me with plain text answers, right? I ask something and it gives me an answer. For example, give me ideas for a YouTube video on the new DaVinci Resolve 20 release. New ideas, not ideas that have already been done. And that last part is key here, guys. That makes the difference. But most of you probably already know how to do this, right? But there's more. Because, for example, one of the most time-consuming things when it comes to making YouTube videos is finding a title and creating a thumbnail. And it will give you a bunch of ideas and suggestions in seconds. You just have to pick the best one and perfect it. Even thumbnails, descriptions, mockups, whatever you want. And look, those mockups, they're never perfect, not at all. I mean, look at it. But just having a bunch of ideas that you can then pick one from and perfect it, fine-tune it, man, it's saving me so much time. And then another way ChatGPT has been helping me and has been saving me a lot of time, even more than what I already showed you, and that's emails, administration. Let me give you an example. I spend a lot of time sending emails, right? New clients, companies that want to sponsor a video, and because English is not my native language, I sometimes literally spend half an hour or an hour trying to write a professional sounding, but not too stiff sounding email. Like, it just eats up so much of my time. So recently, I've been asking ChatGPT to do it for me. I tell it what I need, a bit of context, and it gives me a template that I can use for pitching my rates, for example. There are so many things it can help you with, and that's just the text responses. But you can also let ChatGPT generate images that you can instantly use without tweaking or fine-tuning in your edit, for example. In DaVinci Resolve, let me show you an example. It's mind-blowing. So I'm gonna give you a specific example of a video that I made not too long ago. It was a video about Blackmagic Cloud, and I needed some icons to illustrate how Blackmagic Cloud works, to visualize it. Well, before I would either look on a stock image website, but that takes time to find the perfect set of icons, and well, you know, a lot of times I can't find the style I want, or I need some very specific icons that just don't exist. And then the other option is creating icons myself, but I mean, that's even more work. So now I just asked ChatGPT, and it's insane, it's amazing. This is the biggest time saver, in my opinion. So I just asked it to create icons in a specific style, like they're ripped out of paper. And this is wild, right? Because it creates dozens of custom-made, specific-looking icons in a few minutes. It creates whatever you want. It also generates them as PNGs without a background, so you can instantly drop them on your timeline in DaVinci Resolve. It's crazy. I can't even explain how much time this saves me. And that's just icons, because you can create all kinds of simple graphics and graphs. It can all be generated within a few minutes. So that's literally going from a few hours of work to a few minutes. But there's more. So whenever I want to make a cinematic video, I look for inspiration, right? I watch videos of other creators that have made similar videos, or I look for photos, images, anything. Inspiration. But recently, I've also been asking ChatGPT for ideas, especially when it comes to shot ideas and angles. And it's cool because you can specify what it is you want to film, with what gear, just a camera or a camera and a drone. And then I ask it to create me a storyboard. Now, again, not a storyboard that I'm just gonna copy paste to a video, but it gives me a lot of good ideas. So much faster. It's incredible. And then you can fine tune it, you can ask it to tweak it, add something, remove something, whatever. So the key is that you have to actively look for ways AI can help you. There's no manual, AI evolves, so you have to be creative. Your brain will make AI help you. Something like that. And I bet there's a dozen more ways it can help me save time that I haven't even thought of yet. Okay, and then finally, this is also something I want to show you because honestly, I was flabbergasted. So we're doing some small renovations in our new home, right? And usually, before, I would like Photoshop it if I wanted to visualize the ideas that we have. But now, ChatGPT can also turn a text prompt saying what you want to do in your home into an image, or add it to a photo that you give it. Even the more structural changes. Let me show you. For example, let's say you want to remove that closet and put the stairs, and remove part of the wall. Well, if you give it the right prompt, detailed enough, ChatGPT knows exactly what you want, and it understands where you want the stairs, what kind of stairs it is, what wall you want it to remove. Like, it's kind of creepy sometimes how it understands what's in the picture. It can't see, so, you know, how does it know what's in the picture? Creepy. And you can use this for all kinds of stuff. And, you know, I don't have to spend half an hour or more anymore to make these simple mock-ups for my home improvement ideas. I just take a picture, tell ChatGPT what I want, and boom, done. Now, imagine, because, well, ChatGPT launched in 2022, right? The end of 2022, I think. So that's a little over 2 years that it has been around now. And it can already do all this. So imagine what it will be able to do in 10 years. Imagine, or maybe don't imagine. It is kind of scary, I have to admit. But the thing is, love it or hate it, learn how to use it. Because if you don't, you're gonna get left behind. That's the only advice I can give you now. It's here to stay. Use it to your advantage, or someone else will. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.